Shalom, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and welcome to Biblical Hebrew Foundation. The Bible says that Noah was a righteous man, blameless among the people of his time. Genesis chapter 6, verse 9. This is the account of Noah and his family. Noah was a righteous man, blameless among the people of his time, and he walked faithfully with God. What does it mean that Noah was righteous? First of all, we see that Noah's righteousness is defined by being blameless in his generation. Within the wicked generation that he lived, he was a light within a dark place. Second, Noah has said to have walked with God. That is why the Bible records that he was judged as righteous. What does it mean to walk with God? Before we have a look at that, we have to go back a little bit and see what enabled Noah to walk with God. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 6, verse 8, but Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord. The word for favor in Hebrew is the word chen. And the word chen in Hebrew means favor, grace, and acceptance. Noah was saved by grace. And the evidence of his relationship with God was his walking with God. We can see in the Bible that one of the blessings that God gives is walking with his people. Leviticus chapter 26, verse 12. I will walk with you. I will be your God, and you will be my people. So we can see that Noah came to know God by grace, and he experienced the blessing of walking with God because of his obedience to God's ways, and that's why he was called righteous. Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory, but through him we become righteous. And that's what it means when Noah was a righteous man. It's through Messiah Yeshua. It's by faith that he walked in obedience. Isn't this the pattern in the Bible? Israel was delivered from slavery in Egypt by God's grace. Then they were taken to Mount Sinai and given the Torah, which is God's instructions, as a means of walking with God. We are delivered from slavery of our sins by God's grace and our faith in Messiah Yeshua, Jesus. Then we are given the Word as a means of walking with God. Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 to 10. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not of your own doing. It is a gift of God, not as a result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are all his workmanship, created in Christ, in Jesus, in Yeshua, for good works, which God prepared beforehand, that we should walk in them. As we see with Noah, it's possible to be righteous in a wicked world. Greater is he in us than the one in the world, by being a follower of Jesus, of Yeshua, and thus being a light to the nations. We found grace in Yeshua, who died on the cross for our sins, rose on the third day, and by his blood, if we repent and believe, we have full redemption of sins and eternal life. Let's continue to walk together in obedience to God's word. Amos 3:3. Do two walk together unless they have agreed to meet? God desires a relationship with us. He wants to meet with us on a daily basis so we can walk with him and through him be counted as righteous. Through him be counted as priests, as he's our high priest. Through him, make it to the end as a victorious bride. You cannot walk with God, with Yeshua, until you have first submitted to God, since two cannot walk together unless they have agreed to meet. Yeshua, Jesus God, said it with his own mouth. Matthew chapter 12, verse 30. Whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters. Let's walk with God and be a light to our generation. Let's continue to work the harvest as the one new man, Ephesians 2:15. Bring the gospel back to Jerusalem, back to Jerusalem, and go home. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Jerusalem, Israel, in the mighty name of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Al Yehuda, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Jesus Yeshua. Amen.